YouTube, what's up? Alampa here, making the SmackDown League of my new universe mode. I'm up here. We have a couple. I want to talk about a couple things with you guys. All right. I want to talk about. You guys ever wonder who I want to talk about? Okay. I want to talk about Jeff Hardy for a second. The owner that seems to end his career, blah, blah, blah. He ended his career in I think August 2009. And it was in August 2009. Jeff Hardy went to TNA. And then he was there for like 2 years. Actually, about technically a year and a half. And then blah, blah, blah. He turned all evil. He said that, you know what, he was sick of the fans. He wasn't getting what he wanted to do, what he wanted to do, instead of what they always wanted him to do. Now, I obviously now hate Jeff Hardy for what he did, but honestly, but he gave us a good reason why he did it. I mean, honestly, I turn my back on the fans as well. That wasn't even what I wanted. But now let's talk about him being a drug addict. Jeff Hardy, the fucking drug addict. The guy's got a problem, alright? He just has a huge problem. How can I explain this without hurting any of Jeff Hardy's fan feelings? Okay. He's got a problem. When he wants something, he changes his mind right away. Now, Jeff Hardy, of course, he's a drug addict. I already said that. The reason why Jeff Hardy is a drug addict is he said, man, I'm all stressed from wrestling, and he says, I need some time to cool off with some drugs, with some crystal meth and fucked up. Jeff has got wrestling, I think, 3 or 4 times from taking drugs. And, yeah. And, police said if he get wrestling one more time, he'll be in jail for good. He can't get out of bail or anything. The first time Jeffrey got arrested, his mom bailed him out. The second time his dad. The third, Matt Hardy, his own brother had to bail him out because his parents say, you know what, fuck you, Jeff. If you have a problem, go to rehab because you're not going to bail you out of prison again. So Matt came and bailed his brother out. He knew that his brother had a problem, but he stuck by his brother. Now I do the same thing. If that was my brother, I would stick by him and help him out, and I would have him. Now Jeffrey is still a drug addict. He did go to rehab, but apparently he didn't come out clean. He just couldn't. Rehab didn't help him at all. And yeah, so rehab didn't help the guy. So yeah. Oh my god, dude! If you don't stop me from all my moves, I'm gonna fucking kill. Oh my god, Jeff. And Jeff might come back to WWE next month. TNA. If you go to TNA.com, it shows an interview. You're definitely being interviewed by TNA staff. They ask me, are you thinking of going back to your other company, aka WWE? And yeah, so you know what? Yeah, I am. You know what? I think he says, you made a big mistake, but even WWE. And he says, if I go back, I don't know if I'm going to be with the fans or I'm still going to be who I want to be, not what the fans want me to be. I'm Jeff Hardy, he's still thinking about that. Since he's not that scared anymore. But yeah. If you guys get to my channel, you guys will see my Jeff Hardy spoiler alert saying showing the picture of Jeff Hardy will return to WWE and win the WWE Championship once again. Just so he might, but I'm pretty sure he's gonna return. Plus, he says so himself, he will return. Who heaven knows when, but he will return. Oh, am I predicting Jeff Hardy? Since he's a drug addict, I'm gonna say, Jeff's gonna be dead in my 20 to 30 years. Probably in his 50s or 60s. I'm sorry, Jeff Hardy. Jeff Hardy is currently 34 years old. Now he'll be 37. Yeah, he's 37. Oh! Here comes Matt Hardy. Oh my god! Matt's here to help his big brother. I mean, his little brother, my bad. What's gonna happen? Oh my god, now he's here to help his little brother. Jeff and Matt Hardy, they're 3 years apart, but they were just like, if you search, Jeff and Matt Hardy as kids, they'll show pictures of them when they're like, I think 10 or 11. No, wait, yeah, when Jeff was 10 and Matt Hardy was 13, they were just like each other, but Matt was a little taller, but like right now, I think they're the same size. No, I think Jeff is like one or two inches taller than Matt right now, but yeah. Yeah, I just gonna show you. And yeah, guys, can you believe, I can't believe Matt Hardy actually went left WWE and went to TNA just to join his brother. I personally think what Matt did was stupid. Now Matt is back on the fans. Seriously. Now Matt didn't have a good reason. He just wanted to say, I want to join my brother. That's William. I want to help my little brother out. A year of his career trying to erase and jump on his career. So what the fuck? Oh my fucking god, you got to be kidding me. Fuck, no. Nigga, white ass, you Eddie Fed. Yep, he's another my Christopher, by the way. Oh my god, yeah, he's out. Oh my god, now Matt Hardy, are you fucking kidding me? You ass what? What do they want from me? What do they want from me? What the fuck? Are you kidding me, dude? Get out of here, Matt. I want to be Jeff already. Dude, you need to help your brother. Get out of here. Matt, I never tell you. I'm going to kick your ass. Do you want me, Matt? I'm going to kick your fucking ass. And then I'm going to go and do something else. Finally. Dude, see, every time like someone's trying to feel like that, the person who's spinning still gets to win. What the fuck? What's the point of that? I don't get THQ. They knew that it would probably do that, so I don't know what they meant. It was just pointless, because you know the person who's pinning, when their manager gets ejected, you know the ref is going to pin 1, 2, 3, and the person who's pinning is still going to win. So I think what they did was pretty stupid. It was just idiotic, honestly. I mean, there was really no point of what THQ did on this wrestling event. Alright. That's this first match. That's my second match. Alright. See you guys.